Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to the Manor. Thank you for joining us tonight for the sophomore play, Bad Manners at the Manor. Tonight's sophomores and a smattering of intrepid juniors will be giving you one of the best comedies you've ever seen. Enjoy.
I intended to die inside Flora, but hope it all has fallen to one of your plans. Mr. Weisman, are you sure you want to retire?
Yes, white shirt.
But why would you want to retire? Give me one good reason. That's only one reason. If I paid you more, you'd love books. I hope you care more about books than you do about money. Do you have any references?
Oh, I
just asked the librarian for references. What do I have? Miss Crunch.
Yes, honey?
Miss Crunch. Wait, Lauren, where are you going?
Back outside.
Lauren, the plans to the master chambers of Parch.
The master chambers? Don't you mean your bedroom?
Parch.
They're cacti. Yes. Parch is part of the look. They don't need to be watered for another 3 years.
What's that?
Want to play in here? That's a plan.
But what is it?
A creepy
What?
It's a lab.
What are you talking about?
We were about to die, so didn't you?
Go back outside. Miss Crunch, did I have an appointment this morning for something?
Yes.
Well,
an issue with reporter.
That's right, not a reporter. Gossip companies. Is it too late to cancel?
She's already here.
Go keep her occupied for a while.
Occupied?
Yes, occupied. Talk to her. But don't tell her anything.
Talk to her, don't tell her.
Or just show her something interesting. Keep her busy.
Something interesting.
Oh, never mind. I need to talk to Ronnie Dunn. He's here, right?
Ronnie Dunn?
My attorney. No, I mean, have you seen him yet, Miss Norman?
No.
But when you see him, send him up to my study and tell Leah to come and join us for an important meeting.
Leah?
Leah, my niece, what's the matter with you? Tell her to come to my study right away. And tell Leah not to talk to that reporter.
You're not
seeing. No, not even talk to her, got it? Ronnie Dunn can talk to her because he won't tell her anything.
So, should
I send Ronnie Dunn
to talk to the
reporter? No, send Ronnie Dunn up to the study. Have you seen Sophia yet this morning?
Sophia?
My fiance?
Yes, your fiance. No, I haven't seen her. I imagine she's seen. Do you want me to wait right now for something
too? No, I shouldn't be able to sneak up to my study without her seeing me.
Anything else in there?
No, you've got all that, right?
About what?
Just do the few things I told you.
That's what I was going to tell
you. So where are you leaving, and when do you start? Take care of it then. Get someone to get started right away. We have got to finish cataloging that library. I can't find anything in there. What's the point of having a library? What's the point of having a library?
It doesn't look like all the mini retirement parties with a gold watch. slab pussy, if you ask me.
Did you at least get an audition for me?
Not yet.
What about my career? You said we're going to get a part in the movie.
The right part hasn't come along yet.
Well, nothing's going to come along here. You have to go and get it.
Sophia, I think you got up to it. Why don't you go back to bed?
It's the only place I can go. I can't go anywhere else. I'm practically a prisoner here.
Look, I've asked you to marry me. What more do you want?
To get actually married.
Although that was not a split infinitive, there was still something wrong with that sentence.
I can't do good sentences. Give me a good script with a movie attached to it.
I haven't seen any good scripts.
Why can't you hire someone to write a good script?
Because that costs money.
But you have money.
But I won't have it if I keep spending it.
You're going to spend money on our wedding, aren't you?
Sophia.
Sue.
Sophia.
I'm tired of being just engaged.
Maybe we should disengage.
Hey, honey!
Don't call me that.
How can you even say something like that?
Sophia.
The only way to end actually an engagement is we go away.
Yes, we're going to marry.
You carried me off to your castle. Now I'm ready to begin happily ever after.
We will.
When?
As soon as I work out a few matters.
Matters?
Matters that don't matter to you. Why don't you go run along? Look at some magazines or something. I've got a meeting with Ronnie now. I thought this collection was giving you up tonight. Why don't we?
Why don't we get started, shall we? So, Lauren, is it true that when you go
Can I just have this conversation?
Well, can you tell us the major storm we'll be playing with this kid in color?
Yes, I'm sure I just had this conversation.
Is there anything interesting you can tell us about the library?
Zizi, your readers don't care about libraries. Your readers can't even read.
That way. I need to get some pictures. Can you have some feel where something shocking and they some shocking stuff by the pool? You do have a pool, don't you?
It's a reflective pool. I want to get some if I were you.
How much did you pay for senior hair?
Too much.
And how much is too much? Some people would say you have too much money.
Good question. How much is too much?
I have lots of good questions. Now, how about some good answers?
Do you have any idea why I agreed to consider me?
No idea.
Neither do I.
Hey, Lord, hey, let me let you know something. You need some good publicity.
And why is that?
Isn't it obvious? Everyone hates you.
And what is it you suppose they hate? My wealth? My intelligence? My sophisticated taste? My beautiful fiance? My amazing library?
I think it's probably your shredded.
I've got nothing to humble about.
Don't be so sure,
Lord.
I can certainly write a column that will humiliate you.
Humiliation and humility are two different concepts.
I'll let my discerning readers figure out which is which.
The most that your discerning readers can manage are the captions of the photographs. That's actually a good idea, but it'll have to be this afternoon when the light comes in through the western windows.
How much is your library worth? In fact, well, obviously, how much is your manor?
The number of CT wouldn't fit into your manor column.
Oh, really?
Really? No, excuse me. I have some business matters to take care of. You can finish this interview after lunch.
The interview might finish you, Lord Kenny.
What's that supposed to be? It will give me some time to remember why I could possibly agree to do this interview in the first place.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Aren't you supposed to be up in the study with Ronnie Dowd?
I was just up there and I was like, study.
Why wouldn't it be the study? What a ridiculous thing to say. What's the matter with you? What's the matter with everyone?
How do you get a spice in your manor?
Uh-huh.
trustee? What do you suppose it was?
Trustee?
Dusty, Florin. Dusty.
Oh, imagine that.
Anyway, take it. No sense of making Uncle unhappy.
Why do you suppose he insists on making everyone else unhappy?
Not Florin. Uncle is very sweet. It's just that his sweetness is subtle. Like your housekeeping abilities.
I keep the floors clean. That's what the dirt is.
I think you destroyed more floors than you cleaned.
I thought I told you to go to the study.
Yes, you did, but you wanted to go to the library.
You're
in the study.
Listen to me. Go up to the study and stay there, and don't leave until I get there. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Wow. She's never called me sir before. Miss Grudge.
Yes, Lieutenant.
Did you ever find Marty Allen?
Yes, I
sent
him out
to the pool. I want him up to the study with Leo. No, she's not. I just sent her up to the study. Go down to the pool and get Ronnie down and send him up to the study too. That's what you were supposed to do in the first place.
That's what I did in the first place.
Then send Paul in here. I have to talk to him about lunch and dinner.
Yes.
It's not one thing.
Hi,
Daddy. It's another.
Hi,
I told you not to call me that. That's okay, I'm sure she didn't mean that.
Oh, she meant that with meaning.
Why don't you go back to her?
Why?
Not much.
She wants you to get rid of me.
Now, why would she want that?
Because she just wants all your money. And she's afraid that if you marry
me. Don't even attempt to finish that sentence.
Anybody.
That's it.
What's it?
I told you not to call me that. The wedding is off.
What?
Off. Yes, Paul, I wanted to talk to you about the pasta.
How can you talk about food at a time like this?
Because it's almost lunchtime.
You're worse than a person. You're worse than a beast. I hate you.
She seems upset.
Never mind about her, Paul. I told you before that if you're going to have a tomato base in the pasta sauce, you have to use fresh ingredients. Yesterday, it tasted suspiciously like ketchup.
That's because ketchup tastes suspiciously like tomato.
Let's stick with the formaggio sauce on the pasta for now.
You want macaroni and cheese?
I'd be too afraid you'd serve it still in the box.
I heard cardboard was an excellent source of crawfish.
Is there any reason I shouldn't fire you, Paul?
You want a new reason? Because remember, you've already fired me several times.
Yes, I remember.
But you always rehired me.
Why is that? Maybe because your food makes it so easy for me to be my sure and excellent finger.
Because no other cook will work for you.
Then why do you?
Because I'm hoping to poison you someday.
I think you've poisoned me several times already.
Not on purpose. It's not my fault I'm serving such rancid food. You insist on fresh ingredients, but your kitchen prevents me from getting any fresh ingredients. The freshest ingredients you have are past their expiration dates. In fact, their expiration dates are ancient history.
Paul, you're fired.
Very well, my lord. So at least today we're getting a few more days until you rehire me.
Pack your bags and take your doll match with you. Miss Grudge.
Yes, ma'am.
Miss Grudge, give Paul a salary plus 2 weeks. He's terminated. Let's see if Florin can cook something for dinner.
Florin,
unless you can hire a new chef before dinner.
Florin, you
can't be that much worse than Paul. Wait, we need lunch first. Paul, make us lunch before you pack your things. Then get out of here. No, you're still fired. Starting after lunch.
That was the deal. I was fired now. Now I get my contract plus 2 weeks.
I changed my mind.
Oh, did you? I'll leave you the dressing room if you find me.
So you're not going to make lunch first?
I was on a new contract.
I'll tell you what. You're fired, and I'm not giving you your salary nor the 2 weeks.
Hey, you can't do that.
Miss Grouch, show Paul.
I can find my own way up. You'll pay for this.
Go tell Flora to stop dusting and start cooking.
Zero interest. Zero interest. Are we talking in terms of a loan? Zero interest is quite attractive.
Zero interest in your property, Mr. Stacks. He's not interested. I'm not interested.
But I understood just now that you might be interested in selling Cedar Manor.
What's that got to do with you?
I might be interested in buying.
Why do you insist on wasting other people's time? You could never possibly afford to buy Cedar Manor.
Maybe it's your interest that could. We don't need to write. You should read the scene.
You keep bringing God into this.
He doesn't tend to insinuate himself in things, does he?
You are an extremely irritating person.
Neighbors do tend to rub off on each other, I suppose.
Could you stop talking about being our neighbor?
You don't want to talk about God, and you don't want to talk about being neighbors. The two things that happen to be the topic of the two great commandments. You are aware, I hope, of the commandment to love your neighbor as yourself. If you were to obey that one, it seems, you would love me quite a lot. Not as much as your uncle would love me. Think of that. Loving me as much as you love yourselves. Can't you just feel the love?
Don't say anything to me about where I'm supposed to be.
Everyone?
Everyone. I'll be in the parlor. Let me know when everyone's in here.